Alright, good morning. Today I was gonna make some dark pottery because I don't know, I'm feeling like gosh dang, it's like clouded out with the fog. And so I'm like, well, what's the deal? It's like happy San Francisco, everybody. So yeah, clouded the way. So I'm like, what did I do? Cause of that. What did I do? I'm like, well, yesterday I made the paints with my little, oh, I did this. I know, I'm such, what do you call it? I gotta show you. Yeah, I'm not from Missouri, but I'm still this way. I made this one here. I filled him in much better, so he's much funner. And then I had to change his name. It was Diablo, but I'm like, it's too devil, and so I changed him to Disable, and yeah, so Disable instead of Diablo. But yeah, he's prettier in the color then. And these are tough. These are tough little manugas to film, to photo, because they're having. You have to plunk down with tape, and if you don't have the tape, you need the dental floss. And then I'm going to the edge, which is completely amateur night, I know. And so I need also to put it on like a paper, but I don't know. I'm in a hurry. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, so there is also, and then I made this one, and I don't know, some, I'm unhappy with this character, but it is some kind of a gargoyle stork, and we need gargoyle storks, don't we? But there's a little dragon, so it's all worth it. Yeah, there was an amazing artist a long time ago. I went to school with an Eric Lucero, and he makes the dragons. I don't know where he is, but probably he's on the internet. Yeah. So anyway, so I made that, and then for some reason there is a snake who lives inside the flower, and I'm not sure if that is like maybe I'm eating GMOs, and that's why I'm actually, making the GMO, in the painting there. So it's possible. It's possible. That's the reason. And then yeah, I made this guy recent. He's a Tiperian, the Tiperian trance, and he's just a dude that is what? I don't know. He has a little swan friend, and then down here, oh, and up here he has a like an eagle scouter. And what's the deal with those? I don't know. They're just bulbous. Yeah, I don't know. I'm feeling ornamental. So yeah, so dark. I was thinking dark poetry. I'm here. I'm fresh from France. I should have. I'm weeping it. I have so much to give out. Oh, look at this one. Now this one, I put out on. Oh gosh, he's a pre-flight. He's a pre-flight Zuzu. Now he's just nuts. So he can't even fly. He's just like a little baby bird, isn't he? Like a little baby bird. Just like what the heck. I just know if I have to eat from this plant, and once I eat from that plant, I can fly or something. So that's all he knows in his realm of. But yeah, he's pre-flight Zuzu, and he's actually one of my favorites at the moment. And so and he was one of my fastest drawings. So I draw sometimes I draw really really fast, like sketch, and then other times I'm a little bit more placey. But yeah. But this one I drew on the airplane. And I drew him on the airplane originally, and then I drew this one just yesterday, or yeah, a couple of days ago. Yeah, so I'm not really sure what's the deal with a couple of days ago versus and also. So I'm trying to go back. Okay, time. How it affects you as an artist. This is a couple of days ago also. So I or a week or whatever, this recent, and so I'm like, well, what is affecting me as an artist? Yeah, because the space, this the you know, it was almost more beautiful. It was more beautiful before. Even the pre-flight Zuzu was more beautiful before. And the elephant, very hopeful, So yeah, I've gone a little bit like, this is more introversion, I think so. I think I've gone more introversion. So yeah, I guess so. I guess that's a time wave, you know. And you look at yourself in the time and where you're going and where you've been. That's a funny one. Yeah. Oh my gosh. I know. I'm not looking at the camera. Sorry. Eyes open up. What is the deal? Dark poetry. Yeah. Like I said, I'm. You know, from the France there, I should be weeping out. You know, the tears of the dark. Such a dredge through of cold stones and isolated desolations of entrapments. I have a lot to pull from, I guess so. If that's something that I have as a harbor I can always return to. How great France was for me. It's a dark. Dark tragedy where I live. So I'm not maybe ready even to unleash it. It was that much dark. Yeah, so I guess I've been pushy for its wonder. Just remember it's a still painful state. And because it's painful state, well, my gosh, let's have, forget that. My God, let's enjoy the we call it fog. Yeah. Fog. Oh, yeah, and I heard also, like, an old family friend had written a book on a survival, and he was on the NPR, and I'm like, what's the deal? He writes a book? Yeah, he's an artist, famous artist also. I don't know where he is, but he's there writing a book on survival. I'm like, this is maybe another person. And so I looked, and I'm trying to find on the NPR, you know, give me the when the show is, you know, so I can hear his voice at something. But yeah, anyway, he's there somewhere, Leibran, Jean Leibran. And if he is out there making his art, gosh dang it, you know, give me the link to your website or something, and then I can put it out there and give you an advertisement or promotion. You know, it's all about promotion, isn't it? Here we're networking ourselves into how dark are you or how light are you as our network, you know, what color are you, you know. Yeah, so that would be cool.